first fruits offering. Hallelujah. The Bring a sheaf of first fruits of your harvest to the priest. Look at Leviticus chapter 23, verse 10. That is NIV translation. When you come into the land that I give you and reap its first fruits, he said, then you shall bring the chief of it. Come to the priest and give it to him.
Leviticus 23. This is the establishment, the institution of first fruits in the Bible. It is what God directed Moses to tell the people of Israel. Leviticus 23:10. Then the King James Version says, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when you come into the land which I give unto you, and shall reap the harvest thereof, then you shall bring the sheaf of the first fruits of your harvest unto the priest. Look at verse 11. And he shall wear the sheaf before the Lord to be accepted for you on the morrow after the Sabbath, the priest shall wave it. He shall wave it on your behalf. You bring it. It is an instrument of worship. It is an item of worship. He said, you will give it to him and he will bring it to the Lord. As an acknowledgement that what you have received has come from him, that he has provided it for you. You wave it to him, he accepts it. The priest will wave it on your behalf.
Hallelujah.
That's what the Bible instructs us to do. When you come there, that is the foundation that governs the rest. The first fruit is actually the root. It is the foundation that governs the rest. When you give the first fruit, the rest, which I will tell you later, the rest is blessed. When you give the first, the rest is what? When you give the first fruit, the rest is sanctified. You give first fruit and prophetically the blessings come. Lord, in 2019, in 2018, I am giving my first fruit. Go and order the rest of what comes in during the year. That's what it means. When you give first fruit, what you say, Lord, control of the rest of my level through the year. Order it. Of course, I don't want to begin to say, because I will come there, that when you give first fruit, God is indebted to you. And he does not owe with your pay. He gives an order. What you say is that, Lord, I will give you my first fruit. The rest of what comes this year, blessed, because when you give first fruit is a chunk. First fruit is part of your earnings in the whole year. What you say is that the rest is ordered by God. What comes in there, he orders it. And how does he order it? He blesses it, he sacrifices it, he prospers it. This order was echoed by Moses in Deuteronomy 26. Deuteronomy 26. Can we go there? Can we? Can we? I want somebody to read from either New Living Translation, New Living Translation. As he prepared Israel to enter the promised land, then Moses re-echoed this. Deuteronomy 26. If you have New Living Translation, I would like to read from there. Deuteronomy 26, 1 to 11.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Deuteronomy 26.
Yes.
When you have entered the land, the Lord your God is giving you as an inheritance and have taken possession of it and settled in it, take some of the first fruits of all that you produce from the soil of the land the Lord your God is giving you and put them in a basket. Then go to the place the Lord your God will choose as a dwelling for his name and say to the priest in office at the time, I declare today to the Lord your God that I have come to the land the Lord swore to our ancestors to give us. The priest shall take the basket from your hands and set it down in front of the altar of the Lord your God. Then you shall declare before the Lord your God, my father was a wandering Aramean, and he went down into Egypt with a few people and lived there and became a great nation, powerful and numerous. But the Egyptians mistreated us and made us suffer, subjecting us to harsh labor. Then we cried out to the Lord, the God of our ancestors, and the Lord heard our voice and saw our misery, toil and oppression. So the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, with great terror and with signs and wonders. He brought us to this place and gave us this land, a land flowing with milk and honey. And now I bring the fruits of the soils that you, Lord, have given me. Please, the basket, place the basket before the Lord your God and bow down before him. Then you and the Levites and the foreigners residing among you shall rejoice in all the good things the Lord your God has given to you and your household. This is the word of the Lord.
You can see the institution here. Moses now know the people how to do it. When you have come into the land the Lord has promised you, and you have settled there, and you produce when you have promised you labor, you farm. That time the economy was an agrarian economy. It depended only on agriculture at that time. We are getting profit, animal, they are crops, and that. Those were the measure of their economy. So then our economy has changed. The idea of us for the animal, our economy is not based really on real agriculture or farming, but we are working, we are trading. He said, take the first fruits, put them in the basket, come to the church, the place where the priest will be. First fruits, like light, is brought for money to be brought to the church. When we will be teaching light, you will see that light is commanded to be brought to the church and presented to the priest who is there, and the priest will take it from your hand. But while you are taking it, you will confess and thank God for what he has done for you, because he will do more.
Hallelujah.
You thank God for that. He said, my father, he went to Egypt as just my father went to Egypt. But that Egypt, he left us, he became an Egyptian, he left us, but God did not us. He said, my father was a wandering Aramean. Aramean is the people of Aram, in present Syria. That's the place from which Abraham took off and went to come to the promised land, to Canaan. Abraham moved from all of Aram and came to Aram. Some of us here, ask yourself,
check back, look back, and then you get to Lagos. Look back to the day you came to Lagos, how you were, and look at how you are now. And tell me if God has not been said to you. And tell me if God has not blessed you. Check that. Some of us came as house apprentices. Some of us came as house guests. We have brought it down and we kept it in our house. Some of us came, some of us in Lagos, when she, nine one one at Lagos, in Odomie, in the Rhineland. Nine one one, 911, 1 naira at Miscellaneous Street, Fegue. In the end, I don't know anything about that. It's too much transport. They started with 911, Miscellaneous Street, and Fegue.
nicely about us. We have helped her and she knows it. She said, I will send it as my first fruit. And she did. It should be brought promptly. And when you give the first, the rest is blessed. That is the secret. And when I thought I said, when you give the first fruit, God is now indebted to you. Let us see the benefits of first fruits. Givers of first fruits enjoy God's comprehensive insurance. You know what insurance does? Insurance protects. Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 3. Can you read it? Jeremiah 2, verse 3. It is written. God, givers of first fruits, enjoy God's comprehensive insurance.
Jeremiah 2:3.
Yes.
Israel was holiness.
Yes.
Unto the Lord.
Israel was what?
Holiness.
The first fruit of
increase,
yes.
All that devour him shall offend.
All that devour Israel shall do what? Shall offend.
Evil shall come upon them.
Evil shall come upon those who attack the dead, those who give first fruit. God defends you. God issues automatic judgment on whoever attempts to devour. Givers of first fruits. There is divine protection that is upon you because you have done the first fruits. That's what people don't know. He said, Israel is my first fruits. And in holiness, I've forgotten them. He said, anyone that comes to the mount of the saints shall offend God. And the judgment of God will come on them. Hallelujah. 2. Isaiah 61, verse 7. Isaiah 61, verse 7. Look at me. You see what we have for you. Double portion. Yes, instead of shame. Yes, read it from the scriptures. Memorize it. Instead of your shame, you shall receive your shame,
you will receive double portion.
And instead of this,
you will rejoice.
You will inherit a double portion. Thank you.
would say, "Oh Lord, my Father, remember me for good. In the name of Jesus Christ." Say, "Lord, remember me for good. For the good things, for first fruit, for the offerings I give. Lord, remember me for good." Hallelujah. Again, Proverbs 3, 9, and 10 here tells, in addition to honoring God, the giver of first fruit, the giver also enjoys overflowing blessings from the Almighty. And the person receives an overflow. He said, the Bible said, "He anoints my head with," and what happened? "My cup runs over." In first fruit, he said, "Your barn will burst out. Your barn will burst out." That is, that God will visit you with overflowing blessing when you give first fruit. He said, "Your barn will burst out." And that's the word of God, not my word. It's the God, the giver, is also enjoys overflowing blessings from the Almighty God. Because you have honored God, He honors you. He said, "Far be it from me that those who honor me, I will honor, and those who lightly esteem me, I will lightly esteem them." Hallelujah. 5. It follows that the honor given to God by the person through first fruits automatically attracts greater dimension of honor from God. 1 Samuel 2:30b.
To the place, to you. I will share one of the things that I will have to do.
a priest. Do you know why? He said 44:30. What you give to the priest is that he said, God, let me do this for you.
May the priest do not do this for us. I am an inheritance. That's what I'm talking about. I am an inheritance.
So whenever you give the priest something, what it means is that you are giving something of God. He said, God, let me do this thing for you. Again, God bless you. And I'm teaching you, I will not be here forever. Jesus Christ. That's what the month says. That it is a month of new song for you. The Lord says you will sing a new song and He will bless you. I want to, I have left the fruit. I am praying for you now. I am bringing you what the Lord has for you. In that Psalm 40 verse 3. I waited patiently for the Lord, and He came unto me and heard my prayer. He brought me up also out of a horrible place, out of the lowly place. He set my feet upon the rock and established my goings. May the Lord establish your goings in the name of Jesus Christ. And He had put a new song in my mouth, giving praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear, and shall trust in the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. 7 things the Lord blesses awaiting those who trust in the Lord. 7 things. It's from that particular psalm. 1. He turned me. He turned towards me. May God come towards you. A small boy had fever. And the fever was terrible. His father was panicking. What is happening to me? The father said, Daddy, don't worry. And the father said, don't worry. Just have that. And let the man and see your face. And the face said, yes, my face, I'm your right. And He will cause a new thing to happen to you in the name of Jesus Christ. He did hear me. That's another thing that happened there. He did hear me. He said He heard me. Your prayer will not enter voicemail. He brought me up out of the pit. He will lift you up from the pit to the palace in the name of Jesus Christ. Out of the merry place, there is a place you stay in business, in work. It will not be comfortable. You almost fall, you almost water, you almost sweat. He said, He brought me at my feet. Hallelujah. He said, He set my feet upon the rock. When the Lord sets your feet upon the rock, you stand. You will not fail. The Lord will set your feet upon the rock in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, He established my ways. The Lord will establish your ways in the name of Jesus Christ. That is Psalm 19 verse 17. He said, establish that the work of my hand. Even when you go in Psalm 19, reading from 13 to 17, He said, make that He puts a new song in my mouth. Miracle worker. Oh, your miracle. A miracle today. Oh, man, your miracle. A miracle today. Yahweh. Yahweh.
Your name is Yahweh. You are a miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
Oh, Yahweh.
Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
Your name is Yahweh.
Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Yahweh, you are a miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
You are going to pray. I say, my Father, from now on, let my feet make rapid progress. Pray. I say, my Father. Let my feet make rapid progress. Let my feet make rapid progress. My father, let my feet make rapid progress. Speed up my progress. In Jesus' name we pray. God told Joshua, in Joshua chapter 6, the Lord said, from now on, I will begin to magnify you. We are going to say, I will show myself what is your life. I say, oh Lord my God, from now on, Lord, magnify yourself in my life. Show your wonders that people will believe. That's what he said. Say, Lord, show your wonders. Show your wonders. Magnify yourself in my life. Magnify yourself in my life. Yes. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray. In Luke chapter 2, verse 7, then they said, behold, I bring you good news. I bring you good news. I bring you good news. Angel of good news. They are going to say, my life is available, Lord. Bring good news to me. Bring good letters of good news to me. Pray. Bring good news my way. It will not be intercepted. It will not be transferred. It will not be taken into a mailbox. Yes, it will not enter into a mailbox. Yes, it will not enter the mailbox of my neighbor. The good news you have brought for me will not go to my neighbor. Lord, good news, bring it to me. Bring good news to me. From today, good news. My life, good news. My marriage, good news. My family, good news. In my business, good news. Good news in my ministry. Lord, good news in my family. Good news in my business. Good news in the work of my hands. A new song in my work of my hands. In Jesus' name we pray. In John chapter 5, the Lord met the man who had been dead for 38 years. At that time, the Lord met him. He was a helper of destiny. He had come to help the man who had been dead for destiny. He had come to help the man that people have written up. You are going to pray. As my, I go to pray. My helper of destiny. My ladder of support. My assistance. In my life, look at me by fire, look at me. It is my time to rise and shine. It is my life, my destiny helper, look at me. Take me away from where I have my room, the place that I've been limited. Lord, take me away from there. prayers. You will not suffer prayer abortion. You will not be disappointed. Yes. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray and say, my Father, wherever those that will help me are, don't let them rest until they bring help to me. Pray that prayer. Father, wherever those who will help me are, my destiny helper, don't let them rest until they bring help to me. Wherever they are, wherever they are, wherever they are, don't let them rest. Don't let them rest. Wherever they are. In Jesus' name we pray. To some of us, we have challenges. One challenge is how to obtain blessings. Many of us suffer that particular problem of not obtaining blessings. To some of us, the problem is how to obtain blessings. We cannot obtain blessings. The power that makes you lose good things easily is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. You return, you get a good thing. It does not endure in your life. A little time, it is gone. In the name of Jesus Christ, that power is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to pray and say, Father, make me an obtainer of blessing. A capacity development. Make me an obtainer of blessing. Make me a container of your blessing. Every leakage, every perforation in your destiny, be sealed of every perforation. Let it be sealed up in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray. You are going to pray. You can be a contender. You can become a contender. You can be a contender, but you do not return. Whatever makes it impossible for you to return, the only bread for one spirit, it contends for a while. Thou shalt be a contender, and you shall be a returner. In the name of Jesus Christ, pray, my Father, Holy Spirit, seal up every perforation, anything that causes leakage in my life, spiritual leakage, material leakage, pray, seal it up, seal it up, seal it up, seal it up by the blood of Jesus Christ. Whatever causes perforation, carelessness, foundation, seal it up. Every leakage, every perforation in my life caused by sin, caused by carelessness, caused by evil foundation, by the blood of Jesus Christ, be sealed up, be sealed up, be sealed up. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray and say, Father, make me an obtainer of your blessing. me a contender. Make me a returner. Say, I receive grace to be an obtainer, a contender, and a returner. Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. You are going to pray. I say, you foul spirit. You foul spirit of get and lose. Enough is enough. I bind you. I resist you. Get out of my life. Get out of my business. Get out of my family. Get out of my marriage. You foul spirit of get and loose, I bound you, I resist you. The spirit of nearly, the spirit of nearly. Hallelujah. You foul spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. In Genesis chapter 18, verses 9 to 14, Genesis 18, 9 to 14, go to Sarah. By this time next year, you will have a son. And Sarah was so small. But by Genesis 21, verses 6 and 7, he gave a new son, a fresh son. She was singing the song. But that, in the bed, she was told that she may conceive at the age of something, maybe not 70. Then by Genesis 21, she gave back to Isaac, and her son changed. She is now laughing for joy. Somebody will sing a song, a new song of joy. I said, somebody will sing a new song of joy. And you are going to pray, Father. No matter how the situation is now, let me sing a song of joy out of it. Pray, 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 pray. No matter the situation now, let me sing a song of joy out of it. A song of joy out of it. In Jesus' name we pray. My Father, reverse every irreversible in my life, every irreversible in my marriage, every irreversible in my business, reverse it. Every hopeless situation, when you visit a man, he will never be the same again. Reverse the irreversible in my life, in my marriage, in my business, reverse it, reverse it, reverse the irreversible. Aha! 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 Ay, ay, ay! Ay, ay, ay! Reverse the irreversible. Turn to hopeless. Turn the hopeless to hopeful. Reverse the irreversible. Reverse the irreversible. In Jesus' name we pray. she conceived and she bore a child. You are going to pray and say, my father, I don't know how you are going to do it, but make the impossible possible in my life. Whatever you will do to reverse the irreversible in my life, do it today. Do it now. Now pray, pray, pray. I don't know how you are going to do it. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Two more prayers and we close. We are going to pray and say, Father, before tomorrow morning, before the sun rises tomorrow, put a new song in my mouth. Okay, wait, we are going to pray it. Hold somebody by your side. Hold somebody by your side. Hold somebody, come to somebody. I say, my father, before the sun rises tomorrow, put a new song in the mouth of my neighbor. Pray that prayer, pray that prayer. Put a new song in the brother I was holding, in the sister I am holding. Put a new song. Put a new song. Put a new song in the mouth of my neighbor. Aha! 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 Rabba, ba, ba, ba. Aha! In Jesus' name we pray. I declare the siege will soon be over. I said the siege will soon be over. In 2 Kings chapter 4, 1 to 7, 2 Kings 4, 1 to 7, there was siege over Samaria. But the Lord said that it will be over. Some people doubted and some believed. We are going to pray and say, the purpose of every siege is to destroy those who are inside, to let hunger and what kill them. And make them weak and easy to be captured or destroyed by the enemy. To make those inside be destroyed by hunger. To make them weak. To make them easy captured by the enemy. It shall not be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to declare because the siege is to be lifted in the name of Jesus Christ. We are going to pray. See who did that person. Who did that person? We as a church. Financial siege. Economic siege. Healing siege. We are going to pray. Say, my father. We are in agreement today. From this morning. In all our lives. In our families. In our houses, in our businesses, in our spiritual life, the siege is over. Pray, the siege is over. The siege is lifted. It is lifted. It is lifted. The siege is over. The siege is over. The siege is over. The siege is lifted. It is lifted in your marriage. It is over. It is over. It is over. It is lifted. It is lifted. It is lifted. The siege is over. It is lifted. In Jesus' name we pray. People of God, in Matthew chapter 28, the soldiers saw thieves, but God came with earthquake. The soldiers saw thieves, but God came with earthquake. Lift up your right hand. I said, Lord, whatever you will check, whatever you will break to change my situation, whatever you will check, check it. Whatever you will break, break it. Anything that is stubborn, rock, whatever you will check in my family, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it. Whatever you will break, break it, break rock, check it in my finances, check it in my businesses, check it. Your visitation will change this. Whatever you will change to make my situation free, to bring joy to me, to give me a new song, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it. Aha, 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 aha. Yes, you are indebted somewhere. Lord, check it. Check it to change the situation. You borrowed money. Lord, check the situation. Your health is bad. Lord, check it. Check it. In Jesus' name we pray. And so, Father, as I stretch my hands from my left to the right, Lord, we leave the siege that denies us new songs. The siege is lifted in your body. Every siege over healing in your body is lifted. The siege is lifted in your marriage. The siege is lifted in your family. The siege is lifted in your finances. The siege is lifted in your business. The siege is lifted over your joy. You will sing a new song. You will sing the song of victory. You will sing the song of breakthrough. Then you will sing the song of rejoicing. You will sing the song of healing. You will sing the song of fruitfulness. Your womb will carry child. In the name of Jesus.